Hey everybody, it's Queen of Light 1111. Hope you guys are doing well. Wanted to come in with a quick little check-in for all of you. So what we have today is messages from the Divine Masculine to Divine Feminine. And if you want to book your own personal messages reading, I do offer that at queenoflight1111.com, and you can feel free to book any reading, coaching session, or healing session at that same website as well. Let's get started. Bottom of the deck, conclusion, lovers, and the woman, which would be divine feminine. So there is an ending. There is a conclusion to this relationship with divine feminine at this time. So what he's telling you, he's either come to a conclusion, he's come to an end of a cycle about relationships, about choices in relationships as related to divine feminine. So let's get his messages. His first message today is the energy of forgiveness. He, right off the bat, is saying, I want to ask for forgiveness. Forgiveness for Ten of Swords, for a painful ending, for ghosting you, for stabbing you in the back, divine feminine, and for taking a detour. So he is aware that he really did something very, very difficult and painful to divine feminine. And so now he is in this energy of wanting forgiveness for this very painful ending, for this ghosting of divine feminine, the Empress, and that he has taken, that he took a detour. He's done taking detours. He was threatened. Maybe he got scared. Maybe he was avoiding responsibility in this connection. And so he is ready to come forward now that he's concluded a cycle and ask for forgiveness. His second message is return. He wants to return from a place of strength. Notice the strength card is a major arcana. This is the card of Leo. What season are we in? Leo. What very, very significant portal are we headed into? Lionsgate. Return. Strength. Eight card. Number eight card. Leo. So you can't make these up because you know I only take cards that fly out. He wants to return from a place of strength, be in his personal power, perhaps during Lionsgate, and communicate and compromise and share. And another card of communication, talk, debate, discuss. He is ready and wanting to return with his personal power and communicate and discuss this wounding. There's an energy of him telling you he knows that he released his happily ever after. He knows that he released and let go of a connection that was his emotional bliss. And he wants to communicate that from a place of, you know, where he understands that he released this connection because of money, because of prosperity, because of income, because of finances. He has released money being his source of happiness. He knows that he released love, the ultimate love, the ultimate loving connection because of his attachment to money. So he's telling you here in this reading, his third most significant message is he's releasing happiness being tied to money. And another card of communication. We have now how many cards of communication? One, two, three cards. And I've only got three messages out so far. Okay. His next card is material world. This is about money. This is about the earthly plane. He's saying to you, material world, page of wands. I want to talk to you about my material world. I want to talk to you about my free will choices that I thought were going to make me happy. The things that I thought were attached to love. There's this energy of wanting to discuss the material world and his choices and his free will decisions. There is this energy of third party. So now third party is different. There's a karmic partner card in this deck and there's third party card in this deck. Third party is typically like not very significant connections. It could be also money, job, family. That's what third party can be. Karmic partner is typically like a very, very toxic in and out connection, okay? So he's saying third party. What about third party? That Knight of Cups, he perhaps moved towards third parties and started new beginnings with them or a person or with money, an attachment. And now he's saying, I'm very unhappy with that choice. There were third party decisions that he attached to love to have a new beginning. And now he is very weighed down. He is feeling very trapped. He wants to communicate this to you. He wants to communicate this backstabbing, this wounding, this ghosting. He wants to return and communicate and overcome all of these obstacles. He's telling you, I've released my attachment to money, that money is love. He's telling you, I want to communicate about my free will choices and what I thought love was. He wants to communicate these third party choices where he moved in love to start something new and now is realizing that it was a bad decision. And he's telling you that those decisions were made based off of inner child wounds, where he made offers towards a new beginning in the material world to take a leap of faith forward. But he did that and deceived himself. He did that and he got backstabbed. He did that and he betrayed himself. So he's letting you know the consequences of his decision. And so now his last and final message to you is winter. He's isolated himself. He's iced out any exchange, any sort of giving and receiving to look at himself, to look at his lies, to look at his choices from a place of wisdom, and to come forward into a divine connection with success and victory. So his major, major message to Divine Feminine today is that there is a cycle that has concluded, that he has come to a conclusion about Divine Feminine. And that conclusion is, I want Divine Feminine's forgiveness. I want to apologize for ghosting her, for being threatened by a loving connection. I want to return to her from a place of strength and integrity and communicate and discuss the things that have happened. I want to communicate that I've released my attachment to money as my source of happiness, that I know that I released happiness because of my attachment to money. He's now saying, I want to talk to you about that. I want to talk to you about my attachment, my free will decisions in the material world, and that some of them may have included other partners that I took a leap of faith towards, that now I'm like feeling addicted. Now I'm feeling tied down, trapped, unhappy. And he's telling you that those choices, those offers, were this leap of faith that he took was in deception, was in betrayal, was in his own seduction. And so he has iced everyone out, isolated himself from any sort of exchange to get to a place of wisdom, to see through his own lies, to finally come to a place of victory. So let me know if this resonated. And if you want to book your own personal messages from your twin flame video reading, that is available on my website at queenoflight1111.com. Have a great day, everybody. Bye.